What kind of teleport was that? Oops, hackles. See, I obviously still haven't been, listening to Astrodong's advice. Maybe after a few more deaths, I'll learn about the damaging effects of fire. Yeah, let's try to guard the... How spooky. I'm just gonna go for the throne bomb, I have like no health. Don't pick up the sphere! Okay, good. Bunk. Don't touch any of the gold. Alright, and we can have sound effects back. Now the game feels really slow. Oh man, a secret chest. Oh man, a glass whip. I'm losing time not taking that. Whatever we can down the trapdoor. Gold pile small. Minotaur, he's up above, yeah. You know, I really didn't miss having to deal with red bats. Old wall. Don't think I'm gonna need to go through here. There's a trap door down here, right? Yeah. There's that wall right there. Okay. Coral Riff. Alright, so it's been Conga Riff. So I've got Deep Blue Slate. That's not good. Way bats, no. Junior Fancy working on internet justice. I haven't looked at that speed test screenshot yet, but I'm sure I'll be jelly. Not really like in this situation. Come on. There we go.
Death metal.
Yeah. Alright, watch that fire pig. Alright, you're gonna do some work for me, fire pig. ooze puddle in the bat cave. This is a bad time. Have to go around. Deal with that bat. Or it comes back to haunt me. Thanks for the follow, Jazz Poo. Want to push out the Banshee. I gotta canary against something, we're good. It'll work. Yeah, thanks. Okay. That's pretty exciting to hit that 1K mark. Let's go over here. There we go. Oops, woke up the sentry. I guess let's just follow him. Alright. Deep Blues 4, unfortunately. Not really what I want to be fighting, but not Monk, at least. But, well. Not like I have any say on the matter. No problem, don't even need the bomb. Whew, okay. So we're back up to where we were last run that got off the ground. We're on Aria. Ooh. Okay. Here we go. Not that harpy line, though. Yeah, 2% clear rate for Monk is pretty standard. I say, like, when I'm really trying to speedrun Monk, that's pretty typical on my clear rate for Monk. Hey, Armadillo. I don't like you. Oh no. Oh no, it's fine. They're all just gonna jump on the spike trap. Spike trap MVP, as always. That took me a long time to get my Monk PB just below 10 minutes, let alone to the 6:30 it's at now. Alright, so far so good. Get started off. Topic is somewhere around here. It's to south. Okay, yeah, something's popping out skeletons down there. Nice as that goblin to just immediately head for that spike trap. Yeah, I really feel like story mode should have been a Steam achievement. I mean, it is like, you know, it's essentially the next step up from all zones mode. Like, you're, you know, other than there's all characters mode, but that's like, you know, all the way up there. And like, the story mode leaderboards are so empty. I think part of that's because there's no achievement for it. Like, you look at the speed leaderboards, it's something like 30-something people have finished a run. The 8-bomb one's easy, just go into King Konga practice as Eli. It's really easy to get the 8-bomb. I don't think you even have to be alive once the bomb goes off, just get yourself surrounded by a Konga line and fifth bomb. Tree. Yeah, that's the only thing with story mode runs, is you have to be consistent with Aria. Because, you know, you only get the player after playing two other characters, so... I need to figure out this layout relatively quickly. That was a little sketchy. That shove monster and the clone. Okay. Like, I'm taking that shit out. Okay. No tar monsters, please! Should be able to sleep. There we go. Deep blue. Okay. I'm not risking a throwing bomb this late in the run, so let's go. Okay, this might get messy. Ah, we're good. I'm gonna play it super safe. Keep my available retreat options really clean. Don't touch those bombs. Bad idea. I don't like him. Get out of here. Okay. Please, no troll setup. And Arya's down. We've made it through the big three. Whew. But I mean, when you're playing low percent, no one is trivial. The next up is Dove. Because Dove 1-3 can... Like, 1-3 in particular, nowhere else in the run is it generally that bad. 1-3 can screw you so bad on Dove. Okay. Oh, wait, yeah, that's right. I'm going to be doing a little trick here. Sorry, it's probably going to make the stream kind of hard to watch, but okay, so I'm going to explain this really quick. So, whenever the stairs unlock, you know how when you kill the boss, the stairs unlock and there's a big thudding noise, like a thud noise when it unlocks? Well, rather than the stairs just always being unlocked, they unlock instantaneously when you start a floor on Dove. If the stairs are currently on your screen, you will hear them unlock and can tell which direction they're coming from. But that means I need to be really zoomed out, so everything's going to be really tiny. You're probably going to barely be able to tell what's going on, given my stream quality, but it's going to help me a lot. So everything's going to get itty-bitty, and I'm going to turn the audio up. To the right. That looks like a potion room. Of course, I can't go for it. Okay. Let's see what we got here. Whoa, zombie, please. Rip that, please. Okay. Well, that's better than my last time I made it to Dove. Last time I made it to Dove, I crawled out of 1-3 with half a heart left. Okay, that'll buy me time. Okay. Need a little more. Alright. There we go. It's to the left. The mole digs. I think that was to the right. It's not ever that mimic. We can avoid it. Second thought. Get him out of here. I don't like this. This is really sketchy. Armadillo's wide, please. Get him to roll left. Okay, there we go. Alright, that's the right. I couldn't hear that one over that fucking horse. I should spook him away. I think it's up here, though. Oh, that's the shop. I don't know where I'm going. Maybe this way? Yeah, I think it's bottom left. Okay, let's get those guys behind that little wall there. Let's see if we can just dig around them. No, it's not here. Bottom right, maybe? Don't have all day, I gotta hurry. Okay, there we go. I didn't hear the exit on this one. There it is. Okay. Zone 4. Let's get rid of this warlock. Whatever you do, don't bop. Don't bop a goblin sentry. Gotta remember that. Mummies are hard to deal with. Anything that moves diagonally, pain in the ass. Okay. Alright. 4-2. Clear. 4-3. Oh man, I don't want to deal with spiders at all. I'm gonna go up. Oh wait, nope. Okay, it's down. Map goes down. Okay. I can maybe lure this guy onto this spike trap. Yeah, there we go. Just gotta watch for the bat. That could be a bat cave down there. Not sure I want to risk that. It's sad dove percent. Over to this spike trap. Wrong move, wrong move, wrong move! Okay. 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 Dove is done. Oh, that was scary at the end. Thank the Lord for pixie kisses. I am super nervous right now. Oh my god. Okay. So next we're gonna do Eli. I'll revert the zoom back. Also the audio options, because I don't need to hear the exit. Okay. I'm actually gonna go take another quick pee break. I wanna make sure I have no distractions, even the slightest thing in my bladder I want out of here. I don't want that distracting me. So, you know, maybe TMI, but sorry. Thank you. Okay. All right, here we go. It's time for Eli. I am placing bombs before opening doors in case there's a goddamn, like, ghost or monkey or something on the other side. know what? No. Fuck you. I'm blowing you up. Yeah, I think that was Arboretic. I think that was Lancer. He he saw like an empty secret room and just like, you know, went to mash his way into it, and a Minotaur broke through it like on his way there and killed him. And it would have been his first all characters clear. I think that's my shop. Yeah, that's my shop. Yeah, that was a long time ago, and thankfully I have since gotten a better PB on Bard, or on all characters, rather. Because, and like, when you're speedrunning, it's another story. Like, when you're trying to speedrun, do an all characters speedrun, dying to Bard isn't the most shocking thing in the world, because you're trying to go fast. And, you know, you're also... You know, you're also at the end of the run, so sometimes you're like, oh man, I gotta get a sub-5-minute Bard run if I want a PB. And so then you're pushing really hard. And you just kinda, yeah. You throw yourself into something and die. Great. Up towards the ghost. Yeah, Zone 1 is kind of really scary for Eli, with the monkeys and ghosts. Yeah, that ghost didn't aggro. There we go. Red bats are kind of the worst thing ever. You just gotta kick bombs and hope he moves into it. There we go. Okay, we got a red dragon approaching. I'm gonna back up a little bit. There's also Zone 3 to worry about. If Eli gets a really bad Zone 3 swarm, he has a really hard time dealing with it. Okay, so let me think about this. Oh yeah, that's right. Yeah, I'm totally... You can totally just walk in on this lane. Oh, it's a good thing I did, because I got the right knight opening. If you walk up the center lane with a right knight opener, you're gonna get a hit from you're gonna get hit by that. So yeah, should definitely start on Eli walking in the left lane. Good thing I took the time to stop and think about that, because I don't want to be losing health like that.
Yeah, I gotta watch for tar monsters. Tar monsters are really bad news. On Eli. I'm probably just gonna try and, like, skirt all the tar pits. Wall mimics, too. That's the other bad thing. Zone 2. Okay. Yeah, let's see. Glitch. Let's get rid of that one. Whoa, this Zone 2 swarm, though. Rare, but unheard of. But at least Zone 2, you know, you've got the narrow choke points. Eli's cool with that. It's when it's a Zone 3 swarm and it's a really open map. That's when things get really hairy. Okay. Definitely gonna Ozuma this. Kaga is too random to fight otherwise. Okay, so lure the armadillo out. Okay, zone 3. This is where things can get really hairy. Skelly Riders can be pretty nasty too. I need to be a little more cautious about digging. Like, if that's a Skelly Rider there, if it was a black Skelly Rider on the other side of that wall, that's GG. I should probably actually just not dig at all. I should probably just find the natural route to the exit. Okay, good. No 3-3 swarm. At least not off the bat. Okay. Made it through zone 3. Okay, Coral Riff. Coral Riff 3. I'm not sure if I should be going or like fast bombing him immediately. I think I might go for bombing the tentacles just to avoid a potential trolley. Yeah, there we go. Alrighty, zone 4. Okay, that's fine. Nice, cleared that room instantly. Don't want any items around. Okay. Thank you.
Alright. Death Metal.
Death Metal should be... Oh, I can't even do the trick to get gold. Like, so, fun fact, I discovered a glitch with Eli. If you kick bombs into an arena before stepping into it, and manage to kill enemies with it, those enemies will drop gold. So, Death Metal 4, Death Metal 4 in particular, is a good candidate for kicking bombs in to kill the Warlocks early, and, get gold. That confusion was a little scary. There we go. Eli done. No, didn't even take damage. Yeah, Eli is actually pretty easy. It's just, yeah, zone 3 swarms are mainly what I'm concerned about with Eli. Okay. So that is 5 down, 4 to go. I think Melody might actually be harder than Eli, but I mean, Eli's pretty RNG dependent. But Melody is next on the list. Thanks for the follow, Soul Cube. Hey, Melody low percent is fun, I'm sure. It's just scary because of the low health pool. Like, there's so many things in the game that'll one-shot her. Like, even though Melody has super easy trapdoors, I'm not gonna take any. This is a crappy layout. Minotaur Dragon. Zone 2 is Direbat, so I have no idea what Zone 3 is. Pretty sure Minotaur, since I didn't... I'm pretty sure that's the exit down there, and Dragon didn't come busting through the wall, so... Pretty sure we've got a Minotaur. Got some space here. Okay, there's the Minotaur. And the Wraith trying to fuck me over. Oh yeah, I could have just trapdoored at that point. Should keep that in mind. I I like winning the boss fight by just getting up to that spot and then alternating up and down forever. Fuck you, Target Monster. I'm actually kind of like... The Necrodancer fight's gonna be scary. But even more so, I think the Cadence Necrodancer fight's gonna be scary. Low percent means you're not bombing that stage. And it means you're dealing with full spawns for that fight. Like, I'm super scared of, like, a red dragon spawning and blasting Cadence. How much I would like to take that. Yeah, I've learned that myself, trout stuffing. Remember that I had world records pace melody run that died to Necrodancer because of a yellow skeleton mage. We'll be right back. But it bears repeating, for both Eli and now Melody, these are my first ever attempts at low percenting them. I have not done this at all before. Which is all the more reason for me to be nervous as hell right now. Despite it being pretty damn safe to walk up to the head in this fight, I'm just gonna go through this first phase. Why'd those tentacles not move together? That was weird. Okay, here's where things get really messy. Warlocks can really mess with Melody, since if one gets you, you don't have the option of not hitting it. So, that's gonna be, that's my priority. I gotta watch for Warlocks. Why? Why? Now I can't. Focus Warlocks down before they get themselves in a... Yeah, now I'm gonna have to clear this room out. There we go. That spider's in a really annoying position, too. Okay, 4-1 down. Spider. Mm-hmm. Wall pig. Blade Masters. Okay. So I immediately lead him right back on the confusion trap. Separate them, make it easier for me to... there's all this goo. Okay. So much goo. Okay, let's get that pixie to just come to us. Just wait for it. Okay. In fact, I can just wait the song out at this point. But screw it.
Return of the Necromancer.
All right. I just have to not fist bump shit. I gotta not jump into yellow skeleton mages or bombs. I should be good.
The loot is mine!
One more hit. Yeah. Okay. Melody's done. Alright. We're down to three. We're gonna do Cadence next. Whew. Now, despite Cadence, you know, you can't be fooled. Despite Cadence being the character everyone knows how to play, he's not going to be walking the park. We're going to be dealing with a full Necrodancer fight, which is something that you almost never see. So, definitely something I'm going to have to be really careful about. Okay. Cadence. Come on. Okay. Should be good to exit.
Bad Skelly Knights could still make the fight take a while, but... Yeah, I'm gonna be doing the Lure Strat for Deadbringer. No doubt about that. I'm gonna play it safe and kill that bat. A dire bat is our boss? Yes. Alright. A dragon. No, it's Minotaur.
Death Metal.
Death Metal 1. Okay. Taking no chances with surprise skeleton spawns. Get rid of those for maneuverability's sake. Thank you.
I don't like that clone. I don't like that Wraith. I don't like any of this. Okay, should be good though.
Deep blues.
Have deep blues.
Go around. Probably have to fight some more stuff on the way. Half a heart. I'll be fine. Bottom right then.
Deep blue.
not like blue dragons. Okay. Good. Okay. Oh, Riff. I can handle this. Alrighty. Here we go. Cadence Zone 4, low percent. Let's go. A better place to push it, but yeah, let's get that bat. I got one sentry. Done with this floor. Just let it slow down before I dig out into the exit room. Okay, there we go. Alright, we got... Oh good, she put it in the shop. I don't have to worry about it at all. Mom will help me clear out most of that. And we're clear. So I don't want to touch that wall peg if I don't have to. I might have to. Yeah, looks like I should be fine, actually. Spike trap to our advantage here. Alright. Alright, we got an ogre. I don't want him swinging his club that way. Okay, can swing it there. Okay, dead ringer. Okay, this is the part I'm scared of. Because I am going to be dealing with a full set of enemies. Unless... Give me a yellow skeleton. Give me yellow skeletons. Reanimate. You can summon yellow and black skeletons during this, right? Reanimate. Maybe I have to do a couple of the traps first. Reanimate. He doesn't do yellow until next phase. Okay. I thought maybe I could leave some headless skeletons around the arena to count towards the spawn cap. Yeah, it looks like I'm just getting whites. Yeah, okay. Oh, red bat. I'm not letting that thing live. Wait, there's a yellow skeleton mage. Burn does 2 damage. Okay, here we go. The strats.
the extreme granny strats. Give me more of those yellow skeletons. There we go. That's what I'm talking about. Oh, that first one's gonna die as soon as I pick up the loot. I don't like that bat. Okay, here we go. Here, I need to push them more like that. Like, far off to the sides where they won't be concerned. Oh, is he already at, like, his limit right now? Yeah, he's not spawning anything. Okay, so let's get rid of this bat, get one more headless yellow skeleton. Okay, there we go. We have filled his current spawn limit with headless yellow skeletons. We'll have to do a few more after the mummies are gone. Okay. Okay, so he upgrades like as you do more of the traps. So okay, one more. Yeah, there we go. Alright, yep, he's at his spawn cap. So now it's time to do it. And done. Okay, Caden's done. I took no chances on that Necrodancer. I did not want to see a red dragon showing up and fireballing Caden from across the map. I was not going to take that chance. Okay. Dorian time. Gotta make sure I don't jump onto items on accident. I gotta be very careful. Like, that's my main concern with Dorian, is that I'm gonna accidentally, jump onto a bomb. Like a bomb pickup. Gonna be an awful lot of standing around this run. Just as a heads up. I don't like those red bats. Okay, there we go.
Away bat. Thank you. Touch those bombs! No matter how tempting they seem. Blue's gonna be kind of wonky. Thudding, and I was worried it was a blue dragon. Well, we're on zone 3, still no damage yet. Doing pretty good. That goblin. Goblins are such a problem with Dorian. They're so weird. There we go. There we go. Okay. Death Metal. The first hit on Death Metal is kind of weird on Dorian with the dagger. I'm probably gonna take the time to kill the beetles first, though. Okay, I can. So what does that leave? Coral Rift? Just gotta not get stomped on goo in zone 4 and I sh- ugh. Goo is my primary concern on Dorian. It'd be super easy to jump onto Goo unexpectedly and then just get pummeled. Your bat. There we go. Okay. That spider's kind of annoying, though. Oops. Okay, that's fine. That's my first hit. Have that. We'll open that so we have the option to go in there if we need to. Okay, got the boss aggroed. Spoiler. Ooh, careful. I don't like all the goo in here. Ooh, Pixie though. The fire pig right there, but I should be fine. I'm just gonna wait out the first phase. I can kill these tentacles and the drum tentacles. Can't do much about the others. I guess I could have smacked that one right there. Because the gold is important. Okay! Okay, guys, this is it! It's bard time! I am not going any faster than this for the whole run. Just saying. Like, even trapdoors? Nope, I'm not taking them. Get metal doors.
I was really worried that I was gonna step in through that metal door and there was gonna be, like, the Minotaur just on me already, and there just, like, being nothing I could do. Metal doors suck like that. Well, Squiggo says that, why isn't he just in here and saying that, like, whatever. I appreciate the gesture regardless. Oh, he's streaming? Okay, that's why. Alright. Alright, deep blues. Getting rid of that fucker. I have enough bad experiences for one lifetime with those on Bard. Spacebar. Just to check, yes, it still says low percent. I believe that goes across the entire, like, all characters. Okay. This situation's a little rough. Right now, I'm not super stressed. I'm on the easy character. As long as I just, you know, stay at this nice slow pace, I shouldn't be able to lose this. That
Really? Whatever, he can spaz around up there all he wants. We'll be right back.
Lowest of the low. There it is. Oh my god. Oh. Oh man. What a roller coaster. Yes, the achievement came up. It's, Game Capture doesn't capture the Steam overlay, but the achievement came up. You can check my Steam profile if you want. You will find 100% achievement rate in Necrodancer. I can't believe I got it tonight. Like, after just spending the first, like, hour just bashing my head against a wall over bolts. I'm curious if that might even be a new score record for me on all characters. It is! I got a score PB on all characters! Just to, you know, just to really, you know, bring it all together, that's a score, PB. Oh, man.